Tom St. Feed resigns as the national coach of Trinidad and Tobago.
Stay tuned for more details.
Hey everyone, welcome to another episode of Extra Time TV. This is Andres O'Cloud.
I'm Kevon Campbell.
And for those of you who don't know, I mean, we had live feeds, we had promos. Kevon and I basically were preparing. The national team coach of Trinidad and Tobago, Tom St. Feed, has basically announced his resignation. Yeah. His press release was all over. It was all viral. He released it to the international audience and basically said, you know, the environment is just not cutting it. Kevon, what do you think?
Andre, 34 days and Tom St. Feed resigns.
Yes.
I mean, 4 games, he won one, but lost 3. And goals scored, we scored 8 goals, but we conceded 12. Now, Andre, it seems that just yesterday we spoke about Hearts being fired and St. Feed's appointment. But the time period has been short, but knowing the inner intricacies of the TTFA, it's not a big surprise. I mean, Tom St. Feed, his record before, he has been, as we spoke in our previous shows, bouncing around from country to country. But I was a bit surprised that he pulled the plug. I mean, we don't know exactly what's going on behind the scenes and how the plug was exactly pulled. But
some serious plug pulling.
I would have thought that the opportunity to guide and to navigate a team throughout a hex and play crucial games against teams like Costa Rica, Mexico, and USA, which who are, in fact, some of the Western Hemisphere's finest teams, would have been a good aspect to put on his resume and to go through. I mean, tough away trips to the Azteca and to the US would have been good for him. So I was a bit shocked that he did that, because it was a great opportunity. But there's two sides to the story. So Andre, what do you think of the news, and what do you think that we should do go forward?
I would like to say I'm completely surprised. But I mean, yes, I am, and yet, and I'm not at the same time.
Yeah.
We knew it was a chaotic appointment. It seemed very rushed. You know, we had to do some research to figure out who he was. I mean, he is known. He has done work. We did our research to work in Africa and all those countries within there. He was highly recommended by the Belgium FA, but it never seemed like it never seemed like a right fit. You know, just to go off on the political appointment of the TTFA president, it seems like there's a lot of contention. We don't know what the facts are. We can only say and speak about what we are seeing. It seems it's been reported as a lot of miscommunication and things definitely not going how the coach wants it. Tom St. Feed, like all coaches, you know, I gave him the benefit of the doubt. I had the benefit of sitting with him briefly. And he said some stuff, which he said in confidence. So, of course, I'm not going to disclose everything. It was just a casual chat about his view on things. And he basically just went into further detail about, you know, what he said in what was already said in the press release. That, you know, he needed certain things and he didn't get it. He didn't see it changing, and you know, he decided to pull the plug before the plug was pulled. That's something maybe I could respect. I mean, in any job, if you think the environment is not right and it's not changing, you know, you're entitled to leave. He obviously said, and we are quoting the actual press release here, that he said, you know, that, you know, the president didn't support him. From day one, you know, we have to agree on this. That statement made where, you know, his job is on the line definitely was kind of already, it set the tone for how it was going to go. So I'm not surprised. My bigger concern is the repercussions of this for our qualification, because now whoever comes in, you know, there are rumors of the W Connection coach, maybe Latapi, whoever comes in, is a short period of time. They have to prepare. Who knows who's going to come in? Maybe another foreign coach. How does this affect our qualification? Is it too late to bounce back? Is it too chaotic? There are even people saying that, you know, they need to kiss and make up and bring Stephen Hart back. So it is a complete mess. That's the only way I could describe it. I think we did everything possible to undo our chances. And I think to St. Feed's defense as a coach, I mean, I'm going to speak on what I know, which is in the context of Trinidad. I think, you know, he assessed the situation and pulled the plug.
Andre, I mean, this sort of reminds me of Cesare Prandelli's exit from Valencia. Because here we have two coaches that they were promised certain things. And when you enter a job, all of us have different jobs throughout our lives. When you enter a job, you sign a contract. You expect that your employers put certain measures in place for you to execute your task efficiently.
Yeah.
And if those measures are not in place, your task becomes an unenviable job in reality.
Mm-hmm.
So without those aspects in place, you cannot function, you cannot do basic things that you require to execute your task and to complete your milestones. And that will happen with Prandelli and also Thompson Feet.
Yeah.
And Andre, this sort of knee-jerk reaction sort of reminds me of when we hired guys like Otto Pfister.
Mm-hmm. Which ended sort of the same way.
Yeah, yeah. And Maturana.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, there was a reason why you hired these guys.
Mm-hmm.
And if you don't support these guys, then these are professionals.
Mm-hmm.
They're going to go because they can get offers elsewhere.
Yeah.
They're not begging you to keep them on.
Mm-hmm.
They are her property.
Yep.
So I see that as an aspect. And I mean, he spoke about getting players because I'm not going to just solely blame the federations.
Mm-hmm.
You know, players do have a better part to play as well.
Yep.
And when we speak about getting players, especially the MLS players who are in the off-season, I mean, they could have come back.
Mm-hmm.
And I can take it, guys like Highland and Garcia, their leagues are in the midway point,
mm-hmm.
and they have games every week.
Yeah.
But the MLS players could have probably came back and did a job for us.
Mm-hmm.
And they were sorely lacking against Suriname and Haiti. Yeah. Sorely lacking because the team looked disjointed.
Yep.
And he couldn't get his full squad players that he would have liked to go forward.
Mm-hmm.
So I totally understand his mindset and his reason for doing this. The only thing is that I hope that his coaching staff and everything, that our players learn from them.
Mm-hmm.
Because when you go through several coaches, as with some guys at Chelsea, guys like Terry and Lampard,
yep.
they have good coaching CVs now because they have been through a plethora of coaches,
mm-hmm.
different techniques. So I hope that they take the good aspects from coaching Feet,
mm-hmm.
and also Steven Hart and whoever's going to come in the future.
Yep.
I mean, a stopgap approach could be to hire someone in short term, maybe a local coach,
mm-hmm.
like Fever, but long term we need to actually have someone with a long-term plan that the FA allows to execute that plan.
Yep.
I love what Steven had did, Andre. I mm-hmm. love his procedures. I love his long-term strategy and mm-hmm. how he got us from really down in the depths.
Yeah, because we were really bad when he came in.
Yeah, to quarter finalists of our regional Gold Cup, which mm-hmm. is a big deal.
Yeah.
Twice.
Mm-hmm.
So I hope that they have continuity in the future and things can improve. So Andre, any lasting thoughts?
You know, just to end it off, I mean, we could speak about this for hours.
Mm-hmm.
The whole what's wrong with Trinidadian football, which might be a topic one of these days.
Yeah.
We'll bring in a couple of guests. And here's, because people definitely have opinions.
Mm-hmm.
My major concern is the implications. You spoke about things with the players. When coaches are changing all the time, I mean, at any level, even our kids' level, when you're a teacher or whatever,
yeah.
when you know that person's not going to be there for long, you automatically have a sense of lack of, you know,
yeah.
I don't want to say respect, but you know, like whatever, you don't have to take as much responsibility as you normally would. If you make a mistake, the coach is going to take the fall. And that's one of the side effects of when you change clubs all the time. I mean, yeah. coaches all the time. Being an Inter Milan fan, I know about this. It's why I understood, Zanetti spoke about it at Inter Milan, that one of the problems they had back in the day was that coaches changed so much. That yeah. players, you know, was like, yeah, he's going to go soon.
Yeah.
And it is something I'm worried about. Because we obviously have very real problems.
Mm-hmm.
Do we get a local coach who knows the players? Because one of the obstacles when a coach comes in, he needs to rely on the technical team.
Mm-hmm.
And if it's a foreign coach, he has to trust the technical team to give him players. So any new foreign coach, unless he has an immaculate network thing, check me out, you have to find a way to know the players and you have to trust the technical team. So you either bring him a foreign player in or a local coach who knows the players. And there's only a couple guys, I mean, whether you like it or not, there's the W Connection coach, there's Terry Fenwick, there's a couple others. And the TTFA has to decide, do we go that route and plan long-term and start again? Very much like what Steven Hart did, or bring in a stopgap and hope it works. And it's scary to me that we have come to this point.
Yeah.
And we can only see how the soap opera that is Trinidad Tobago football continues. So
yeah.
And then there's the clashes with the Pro League, which is a whole other topic as
yeah,
well. So
absolutely.
Kevon, I'm depressed about it. Me and too. We'll just see how it unfolds. So with that being said, Kevon, where can we find you?
Kev868 on Twitter and Instagram, Andrew.
You can find me at Andrew Soglal on Twitter and Instagram. And as we said in our last video, apparently people are challenging me in FIFA.
Yeah.
So I'm going to put it in the graphic below. It's at Dracul10.
Mm-hmm.
So if you want to take me on, I only play at the wee hours in the morning sometimes. So if I rage quit, you gamers know what that means.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, now you know what it is. I'll just blame the internet connection. So also, don't forget to like our Facebook page. Also, like our YouTube channel and also subscribe, because when you do that, you qualify for chances to win
FIFA 17.
Yes, and tickets to upcoming Trinidad and Tobago qualifiers, both whatever level it is. So do that.
Yeah.
Okay, guys, so don't forget, if you like and subscribe our page on YouTube, Extra Time TV, you instantly qualify to win a copy of FIFA 17. So don't forget, like and subscribe.